What has happened to Call of Duty? Call of Duty is the franchise of games that I grew up on as a kid, and today is a day that I would never have imagined we'd be in, but here we are. This is the time where I finally need to make this video because I cannot stand what is happening in the scene right now, and it just needs to be talked about from my perspective. So with that being said, I hope this video can be a way to add to the stance that is the COD community and video game fans in general being upset about the state of this franchise, and we can have a conversation here with this video and come to an understanding that can hopefully light the spark to bring this franchise back to the forefront. If you like what I have to say in this video, please hit that like button and share the video so that we can get more people in here to talk about it. And of course, if you are new, be sure to hit that subscribe button to tune in for more content coming down the line on my channel. Also, let me just start out by saying Happy New Year's to you all who are watching, and I hope for a fantastic 2022 for everybody. Also, please do enjoy the gameplay that you see in the background, which is from my favorite game of all time, Black Ops 2. And of course, it features a hacked lobby and a trick-shotting free-for-all lobby, which it's just about right for what Black Ops 2 has become in the year 2022, I'm not gonna lie, so do enjoy that while we talk. So Call of Duty was the game I grew up on from a mature rated level perspective. Call of Duty 3 was my first Call of Duty game, but this was before the time when mature rated CODs were the ones I played. I played Call of Duty 3 way after it released, and so my first Call of Duty mature, my first mature level Call of Duty game was Black Ops 2, the one that you're seeing on screen right now. And from then on, Call of Duty has always been my staple for first person shooter games. I didn't grow up with Halo or Battlefield, and to this day, I am forever happy that Black Ops 2 was that game I started with, because not to beat around the bush, but it legit changed my life. I don't know to this day where I would be if Black Ops 2 did not exist. That game is my favorite game of all time, and I think it's one of the best we've ever had. And now to segue into the real conversation, I don't know how we went from that to now where we are in today's time with Call of Duty Vanguard. It really does blow my mind where we have gone with this franchise of games. So right now, if you are out of the loop, Call of Duty is basically in the worst place that it has ever been in maybe its entire lifespan. I really don't know if we ever have been through a worse time with the franchise, at least from my view, ever since Black Ops 2. I know I didn't grow up with any game that came before that, but from what I know and what I've seen, the games that came before Black Ops 2 were nowhere near close to what it is now. I've played every modern Call of Duty game for enough hours, and to this day, I have not seen it like it is now with Vanguard and Warzone. Even Warzone is having its own problems. I mean, let's be real here. Warzone has been a problem ever since it first released 2 years ago now or so. And yes, I know that's maybe the most controversial thing I say this entire video, but I just don't care anymore. Warzone is the most overhyped, overrated piece of crap that Call of Duty has ever put out in its entire history. Game, weapon, map, I don't care what it is, Warzone is the definition of what I just said. To this day, I have been saying it for almost a year now. I really truly believe that Warzone is the secret and silent Call of Duty killer that no one ever saw coming or wanted to admit that it was. And don't get me wrong, do I acknowledge that Warzone brought back the fan base for like a year or so? Yes, of course, I don't deny that, but you in the same sentence cannot sit there and not say that Warzone has done more bad things for this franchise than good. I mean, come on, man, just look at the state of that game. We have had hackers in that game ever since it released. We have bugs and glitches that are game-breaking in certain instances, still in the game that aren't fixed. The maps that we have gotten aren't that great. Verdansk is one of the worst maps I've ever played in my life. Caldera, from what I've seen, doesn't look all that much better, to be honest, either. The game is a disaster, and now that it seems Activision wants that to be the future of the franchise, then, I mean, I'm sorry, but we are in for a long ride of hurt then. I'm sorry to say this for all the Battle Royale people and Warzone people out there, but Warzone is simply not the way to go. You cannot base your entire game solely off another genre of video games. Call of Duty has always been a first-person shooter game. It was never meant to just be a Battle Royale-focused game. This is also something that I've touted a lot before now since we've seen plenty of examples of it. And that is, at this point, putting a Battle Royale in your main game negatively affects the main part of the game in many ways. And let's run through those examples real quickly. With Call of Duty, you had Blackout and Warzone, which started back in 2018 with Black Ops 4, which is where, in my opinion, the downfall of COD really truly started to begin. That's when the slew of bad games became a thing for this franchise, and a lot of that has to do with the Battle Royales. It has shown a lack of care for the actual main game, and also to make it clear, when I say main game, I mean the campaign, multiplayer, and whatever the third game mode is, whether that be zombies, spec ops, or whatever it may be. Those core aspects have suffered starting with Black Ops 4 all the way up till now with Call of Duty Vanguard. This might come off as another controversial thing to say, but in the last four games, of all their game modes, I think the only one that has remotely been good has been Modern Warfare 2019's campaign. For as much as I do not like that game, the campaign is good. There's no denying that. The only ones I haven't played are the Cold War campaign, Vanguard campaign, and Vanguard Zombies. But even with those, I haven't heard the greatest of things, so for now, until I ever play them, I hold it to the people that I trust to speak on them and give their opinions on it. So there you go. That is just a rundown of what I've done with COD the last 4 years or so. The last 4 years have been spent primarily focused on the Battle Royale genre. Blackout and Warzone have been Activision's primary focus, and it only is showing every year that they don't care anymore for the main game because they know that BR will make them the most money even though it's free to play. They get all their money from game sales, even if they are failing significantly as per the UK this year with Vanguard, and through the battle passes and skins they continue to put in their games. Because for some reason, this franchise just can't seem to do anything new without copying other games that did it better than they did. And that's another aspect of this franchise that I just despise so much, is that the originality and ability to innovate is just completely gone. If I'm correct in saying, I think we first saw the most significant copying of another game back with Black Ops 3. And Titanfall came before Black Ops 3. COD saw that movement in that game and was like, yeah, let's do that. We also saw it with Specialists as time went on, which was another thing to copy from games like Rainbow Six Siege and Overwatch, who were big at the time. We've now seen it even more the last 4 years since Black Ops 4, with the addition of Battle Royale, since everyone wants to be Fortnite now all of a sudden, especially with the Battle Pass system. And now apparently, I didn't even know this, but Cold War, I guess, full-blown copied a logo from the show Sons of Anarchy to make into one of their prestige albums, and you'll see it on screen right here. Like, dude, what? And it's like, of course, we are now seeing it be so blatant with the fact now they just have to copy their own games, since Vanguard is literally a Modern Warfare 2019, World War II, and Cold War in a World War II skin. I mean, there is nothing different there. Oh, and how could I forget? If you are somebody who doesn't know already, next year's COD is just going to be a sequel to Modern Warfare 2019. I mean, how fun. It's almost like that's the last thing that I want personally. Guys, I hope you understand this. Nothing is going to be that different next year. I just hope you all prepare for that when it happens. Expect another Modern Warfare 2019 lookalike. Now let's turn our attention to today's time and what is going on right now with the state of Warzone and Vanguard, because that's where the big problems are. So right now, COD is arguably in its worst state that it has ever been in, and that is due to the fact that both Warzone and Vanguard are just broken, unfinished, and just about every negative word you could say about it. Nothing is working in either game, and it's only becoming more apparent that Activision and the devs just don't care for the game anymore. Campaign, from what I hear, was a bust and not that great. Multiplayer is a broken and not being fixed, and Zombies has just been left for dead at this point. No updates, there are still missing so many huge things, and no one plays it anymore. Warzone, on the other side of things, is pretty much the same. A broken mess to where even if a new update comes out, not only does it break the game, but it somehow manages to break older games too. It's truly mind-blowing to me what is happening with this game. You would think Warzone would be way better off, but even that is being handled poorly. That isn't even the end of it either. So many game-breaking bugs and glitches being in the game and not fixed to the point where players are going invisible and hackers are still a presence even after the new anti-cheat got implemented. It's seriously just a dumpster fire right now for the entire Call of Duty scene, to the point where, again, I would argue that this is the worst it's ever been. Even when we had games like Infinite Warfare, and to a lot of people, World War II, the community was still on board because at least the game was finished and wasn't experiencing the problems it is now. It really seriously just blows my mind that we went went from having two studios who had 2 years to work on a game to now having three studios who had 3 years to work on a game, and yet we have gotten the worst of the COD franchise in that time. Like, where is the logic there? If anything, you should be having the best of COD ever with that amount of time, but we continue to see these games get overstuffed with stuff that doesn't need to be there and too much to make it overcomplicated. I've always said this, if you make the game simple enough, anyone can understand it to where it makes them want to come back for more. That's what the original games did so well. They gave us enough to where it made the game feasible for people to play. Nowadays, it just seems like they just want to lend the hand to anyone who may not have a well-functioning brain so that they understand the game. We see that enough with so many of the unnecessary additions they have put in, like doors, making maps more camper and new friendly, and just overall giving it a more younger and kid-like feeling. That is another thing for some reason COD feels it needs to appease to kids specifically more than any other age group nowadays, which makes no sense at all. Call of Duty is not a kid's game. I'm sorry, if you disagree with that, it's the truth. Fortnite is a kid's game, not Call of Duty. COD has always had that mature, older feeling to it, to where it was for the older teen and young adult age group. It's like, you know how on every game there is the rating? It'll either be rated E for everyone, T for teens, or M for mature. You could basically slap the T rating on COD nowadays, and it would make more sense than the M rating. And look, I'll say it again, but this franchise just doesn't have an identity anymore. It doesn't know what it wants to be. It wants to be too many things at the same time without wanting to be its own thing. And that is severely hurting it. I know it may sound like I'm being a broken record here, but guys, please hear me when I say this. I love Call of Duty. This is the game I grew up on from a franchise perspective. Of course, I did play other games around COD, but COD was always my main focus. I want this franchise to be good, I really do. When COD is popping off, nothing can stop it. It is truly such a fun and addicting game to play when it is good. Just go back and look at games like Black Ops 2, Modern Warfare 2, Black Ops 3, and so on and so forth. I have put more hours into those games in 3 days than I have the last 4 CODs combined in 4 years. That is saying a lot. I just will never understand why COD doesn't follow the old formula while also doing new things, because I'll admit it, the franchise has to do new things, but not at the expense of getting rid of that old formula that works so well. People say it all the time, don't fix what works if it doesn't need fixing. Those old games and their formula is what worked for Call of Duty from a quality perspective. You can argue what the most recent CODs have done worked best from a business perspective, but think about what that means. That means the companies benefited and the fans being worse off from the quality of the game they are playing. Because as of right now, it's all business for Activision and these developers, as far as I'm aware, and not a care in the world for the quality of their games. It's really just a sad sight to see, and to be honest, I don't know if it will ever go back to normal. Until Bobby Kotick, who is the CEO of Activision, is fired or leaves, and many of the other corporate hacks at Activision are ridden of, then things will just not change. Also, I hate to say this, I really do, but Sledgehammer Games, you guys should not be making Call of Duty games anymore. I'm sorry, but this deal you guys have had with COD must come to an end. To be fair, your games haven't been absolute garbage, but Advanced Warfare and World War II just didn't hold a candle to any other game. And now here with Vanguard, I feel it's showing that either you don't care about your game, or you are deliberately hurting it to spite Activision, which in turn hurts the fans playing your game. I'm sorry, but at this point, either a new replacement needs to be found, or we just go back to a two-studio game commitment to where they also get more than a year for a game's release. That's another thing that must change, is the yearly release must come to an end. Either we go to a two-year release or a three-year release. I'm done with the yearly releases now. It's getting old and it's getting ridiculous. So with that being said, guys, I don't think I've got much more to say. I am not looking forward to next year for Call of Duty and will probably be saving my money until big changes come. Because also, let me just say this. This video is not meant to go into any of the sexual assault or sexual harassment stuff that Activision has been involved in recently, but I refuse to buy any more of their products as long as those disgusting people still work there, and to include that into the games are suffering anyway, so it's not like it matters. From everything that we say with that story, it's just sickening that they continue to be there and not face any repercussions. It would take so much for me to want to buy the new game next year for right now, and it doesn't look like anything is going to change within the next 9-10 months until the next game releases. So guys, again, that's going to do it for me. I mean, I just wanted to get this video out to you guys as far as a first big video of 2022, and hopefully this can spark some conversation between both aisles of the community, and we can come to an understanding on things. So guys, if you like this video and want to see more of it in the future, be sure to hit that like button. Again, share the video to anyone you may know so we can get more people in here. And if you are new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. I hope you all have a fantastic week ahead, and I will see you all in the next video. Peace.